Hey!
Hello,
Yeah!
welcome
Welcome!
to the regulars. I'm Donna.
Scott Jackknife Tone. Hello!
Hello, everyone, and welcome. I was going to do the You are
It!
here. It is happening. Happy Halloween, one and all. Welcome to the regular Spec Spookular. And y'all, you might be wondering what our costumes are. And let me just tell you, we are brand new owners of an above ground pool.
Hey, Scott and Donna don't own the same house. We both own a pool together, above ground pool.
We did date for a bit, and then we just decided to be platonic love partners, and so we decided to go in on a pool.
Yeah, we dated. It was grade three. Great, long time ago.
Yeah, we saved up for a very, very long time.
But we were old souls. We were just like, let's go straight to platonic. It's
Now,
when I learned the word platonic.
I will tell everyone watching, I did think that Jason and I would be lovers in this couple, and I was
Yeah.
made aware right before airing that we were actually platonic. And Jason changed his costume so much that now, y'all, he looks like my
What are you talking about?
son. Oh, wow. Well, I
Mean, I
want
could put the other shirt back on, but
to. I mean, I just think that when we were planning this costume, I went one way and shared the journey with Jason.
I shared the journey with you.
I was sending you Amazon links and you're like, yes. And then when we showed up today, I was
Yeah.
like, your outfit
Is
is it.
exactly what I told you.
You said you were AU
I
Amazon
said
hat
mesh
and you
cap.
got it, but you've got it backwards. No,
Mesh cap.
it's seen
It's
the
my
front.
drinking hat.
But what does the front say?
It's my drinking hat.
Hilarious. This is very fun. Thank you, everyone, for joining us. I'm already shiny. This wig is very heavy. We have so many guests. This is going to be a real fun time. We have a lot of new
How
chatter in
about this?
the chat. Everything you're doing is making you look younger, and it's making my costume far more confusing.
So this is me. I have to, this is how I have to go out in the world. This is how I look younger.
Jason also created his very own cornhole, you guys. So okay.
Trick or fucking treat, everybody. This is amazing. I'm so happy we are
Trick,
doing the.
we're
What's
doing it.
that?
I know,
We're
I'm
doing it.
agreeing with you. Trick or fucking treat, everyone.
Cheers.
Cheers.
And if you guys want to get in the pool, get in the pool. It's
Just
warm.
y'all, you guys got to get in the freaking pool. Now you're probably wondering, hey, you're talking a lot about your pool. What do you want to know about the
Splish splash.
pool? It is a great frigging pool. Do you want to talk about it, Jason?
Yeah, it took a while to put up. I decided to do it on my own. We didn't want to. We want didn't want to like you know get hired professionals. So has a slight hole. We have to fill it up a couple inches every hour because it slowly drains.
And just for reference, I will show you a photo when we purchased the pool together. Now, again, I do want for reference everyone to know I thought we were lovers and we were platonic. So you take as you will when you see the photo. You can see here I am waiting for some lover attention. The pool has broken.
Well, you're on your phone. I don't know how you're waiting for attention.
I was texting, I was looking for
I was
attention.
texting you.
Exactly. So, we're really super excited, y'all. Should we get our first guest in here?
Well, before we get our first guest in, I
Yeah.
think we've had people like throw out some stuff. Why don't we we've got some scary stories, and I think the first one we should do, I imagine, is it is Friday.
It is Friday, y'all.
It's Friday, and so we've got a special surprise for everybody because it's Halloween. I know this doesn't look spooky because it's an above ground pool, which is the best.
But I think I kind of look spooky. I am wearing a bathing suit top and a mock turtleneck because my tits were out of control.
You do look like the person that would get killed first in a horror movie, yes.
Oh, chase me, chase me. I am prone to trip.
I'm the guy that walks in and it's like, I'm not scared of anything, but then I'm the most scared throughout the whole movie.
Yeah, you reveal halfway through that like your mom died and you haven't dealt with it yet.
Yeah. And I think she's here killing us all.
Exactly. You're the one who's like, by the way, we're all here because of me.
Yeah. You can tell by all the smears of the cream cheese on the walls.
Okay. What?
She cooked with a lot of cream cheese.
Okay. All right. Well, let's leave the pool for but a second. So tonight we are going to have a night of scary stories from our deep friends of the pod. You know them, you love them, who have sent in some scary stories.
It's Halloween.
It's Halloween. And so we thought, because it's Friday and we haven't seen them for a while, our first spooky, what are you laughing at?
I'm looking at the chat's lit up tonight and it's fun as hell. Jameson thinks I'd be the killer.
This is really going to distract Jason, but let's just get into it.
Yeah.
I'm burping. Sorry about it. I should make some more money on OnlyFans for it. Here is our first spooky story. Are you excited?
Hell yes.
Okay, here we go.
I mean, I'm also scared.
Ooh, it's Mr. Casual's
Casual Friday.
Spooky story. Here we go.
Hey, yo, I'm going to tell a spooky story about the first time I smoked weed. It was a night much like tonight many years ago. I was 15 years old, and I was hanging out with my friend Rick and a guy that was 2 years older than us named Chris Vermin. And Chris Vermin was like, hey, do you guys want to smoke some weed? And me and Rick were like, okay. And so we did. But I wasn't even sure if I really felt anything. But Rick felt something. He felt not good. He's like, I got a stomachache. And so he went home. And I was like, I can't go home yet. What if I'm high? And Chris Vermin's like, I got a plan. Let's go visit Tony. And I'm like, Tony the gangster? And Chris Vermin, what a piece of shit, is like, uh-huh. And so we go and visit Tony. And as soon as Tony opens the door, he's like, I'm fucking hungry. Let's go eat. And I'm like, okay, I can eat. And he's like, let's go to Hoy's Wonton House. And I'm like, fuck yeah, Hoy's Wonton House. And so we get to Hoy's Wonton House and I order the hot and sour soup, but like the huge bowl for like 10 people. And I'm like, leave the ladle in there. I'm eating the huge bowl. And I did. And then afterwards, I'm like, okay, maybe I could go home now. And so we all get up to leave. We leave the restaurant. But as soon as we leave, Tony turns around and looks at the window of the restaurant. And he's like, do you see that adult man there? And I'm like 15. I'm like 120 pounds. And I'm like, yeah. And he's like, that guy owes me money. And he goes up to the window and he's like, duh, duh, duh. Hey, come here. And the adult man's like, fuck off. And he's like, duh, duh, duh. And he's like, come outside. And the adult man's like, okay. And him and his buddies stand up and they got puffy leather jackets and tight white jeans and they come outside and Tony's like, hey, you owe me money. And the guy's like, fuck you, and goes to grab Tony and Tony pulls out a gun. And the adult men are like, holy shit, and they run off. And Tony's like, fuck yeah. And he's running down Kingsway with a gun in his hand. And Chris Vermin looks at me like, what do we do? And then Chris Vermin runs off because he's a piece of shit. He runs after them. And I'm like, okay. And so I'm running after two adult men for like drug money. But I'm so far behind that they've already run around the block. And now the two adult men are coming back towards me. And I look at them and I'm like, oh my God, this is where I die. I've only smoked weed once. I've barely like... Grace Chan kissed me, but like I haven't had sex or anything. And I'm like, oh my God. And they're like, fuck off. And they run past me because, of course, there's a guy with a gun behind them. They jump in their Pontiac Fiero and tear off down the street like Hardcastle and McCormick. And Tony runs up and he's like, why didn't you stop them? And I'm like, I'm a little boy. And Tony was so disappointed in me. Chris Vermin was embarrassed that he brought me out. Was the first time I smoked weed.
Oh man, Mr. Casual Friday, bringing it. Although I was really disappointed he didn't blow out those candles at the end.
I thought he was.
It really felt like that was the end of a Vincent Price sort of thing, and then.
Exactly. It's like the first time we jumped into our above ground pool, and I thought we were going in for a kiss, and you blew in my face, and I just fell in. Oh, now, y'all, let's go to our first guest. Okay, she needs but no introduction. She is the most wonderful, loving, caring corner of the internet. We talk about her often. Jason,
you already know. I can bet you anyone in the chat knows who we're talking about already.
Jason has started authentically smiling because I think she might be the truest love of his life. Give it up for the one and the only Two Little Sandwiches.
Whoa.
How are you?
Hi, pals.
I'm
doing great. I want to clarify. I'm Stacy's mouse.
Yeah, not Stinky Mouse. Stacy's mouse.
Stinky Mouse. Jason was like, "Did you say Stinky Mouse?" I'm Stacy's mouse.
No, you are the mouse in my house. And I will tell you, there was a rattling in the cupboards last night that forced me and the dogs into bed at 11. there was a huge like clatter in a cabinet and Burger was looking into the cabinet. That the last time he did that, there was a bird in a cabinet. So we went to bed.
Solution is go to bed. This is why you die first in the horror movie.
Chase me.
Did you guys see the mask in the window? I got a better idea. Why don't we all go to bed?
Jan, you look sexy as all hell.
Oh, thanks. I really wasn't going for that like sexy animal.
You mean the Betty Boop mouse? Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah, once I went with the wig, I was like, well, there's no turning back.
Yeah, but listen, like I love that wig and that's basically your hair. Well.
I wish I could never pull off a bang like this.
Yes, you are. That's what I'm saying. You are pulling.
No, but my hair is very fine. So it always looks a bit like I just came out of the pool.
Nothing wrong with coming out of the fucking pool.
There ain't nothing wrong with coming out of a pool.
You know what's only better is getting in back right back in that fucking pool.
Oh, because you realize it's too cold?
You guys need any sunscreen?
Hold on. You guys need some. This was not planned. I just have some. Readily available at the door. I got an SPF 60.
Yeah, I'm on a 50 or 30 over here. I'm fucking letting the sun touch me.
Can I ask you, and I welcome everyone in the chat to also tell us, you got a favorite pool story? You got a favorite pool memory?
You know me, I'm always in the pool.
You love a pool.
I love the pool. I have a pool in my building. I love swimming. Probably my favorite pool story, we've told this on the podcast before, is that I thought that you and our friend Ashley were going to come over to my house and go for a swim. So I answered the door in my bathing suit and I opened the door and all of our friends were there for a surprise party for me.
I remember that.
That was annoying.
We also brought a birthday cake. Can you jump out of your own birthday cake for us?
Gladly.
Now, we did want to like just bring it up into the chat because Two Little Sandwiches is really popping off in a huge way to the point where I'm texting you all the time going, when's the book, you know? So I just thought that what we could do, I'm sorry, everyone, I'm going to be touching my boobs a lot today.
I'll do it too.
Yeah, everyone just touch your boobs.
My boobs are really out there too today.
No, your boobs are great. I was going to send you a photo of me in this bathing suit top without the turtleneck. See, I should have just done that.
I need to trim mine down. How do I get rid of mine?
Great, Jan, the shirt of it all. It's very clueless. It's very like, this isn't a lie. Oh,
across from Jen is sitting her boyfriend playing video games. So she's watching all this.
Well, we talked about this on the podcast, but that TikTok challenge where like women would come out naked while their partners were playing video games and go, hello. And some would be like, I got to call you back or like be playing and then be like, but some were like, what are you doing? And that would be my fear.
That would be Sheldon for sure.
I'd be playing video games every day, but just staring at the door.
Well, I said that would be Sheldon, but it's not a slight against Sheldon. It's because I just am always walking into rooms with no clothes on. So yeah, it's kind of de rigueur around the house now.
Well, what we wanted to do in the chat and also to help, you know, we're all stuck inside. It's Halloween and some people are struggling with the spirit and like being like, I'm just forget Halloween this year. So we thought we would go to you to ask if you're inspired by tonight and you're like, I'm going to do Halloween. What are some last minute tips and tricks to get people into?
Like if you knocked out 2 weeks ago and then you woke up and you're like, today's the 31st. Oh, fuck. I got to get out this, man.
Exactly.
That's how I live my life.
You know, I mean, like, I think like with show folk like us, we're very lucky because I don't know about you guys, but I had like a giant Rubbermaid full of wigs, just going like, what could it be? Like that scene in The Great Gatsby where she's just throwing the shirts.
Oh, 100%.
That was me. But I think
that Leonardo DiCaprio?
Yeah, I think it was Leonardo DiCaprio.
Just checking. Okay, never mind.
But if you don't have that, I just say anything in your house can be a costume.
Anything.
Anything.
That's such a good idea. I mean, look.
Yeah, Stacey's wearing a mock turtleneck under a bathing suit. That's a costume. I think you could get like a bed pillow. There was that like that TikTok challenge before where you would get like two bed pillows and then just tie a belt around them.
Yes.
You're a high fashion model instantly.
Oh,
awesome idea.
Yeah.
That's such a great idea.
Put a lampshade on your head. You're a lamp.
The great
or you're like John Belushi.
You're John Belushi at a party.
At a frat party.
At a frat party. Put socks on your feet or socks on your hands and gloves on your feet. You're an upside down clown. Like instantly.
That's actually a really great one.
Yeah.
And also a huge tip that I'm finding for myself is that candy is already on sale. It's already on crazy sale because no one's going to trick or treat. So I'm exactly. How much was that? $5?
You can get it in the store now for $5.
So there
you go. I'm coming back to Canada just for the chocolate. Like it's not good here. I'm sorry because I know we have a lot of Americans in the chat. But I had a Twix the other day. I was like, this isn't a Twix. This tastes like chemicals. This is weird as could possibly be, man.
Because they can still use paraben in chocolate in America, yeah. I think.
Ooh.
I think that's why.
Solid paraben. Anyways, this is these are great, Jan.
So we ask you, because Jan's going to be with us for the whole show. So if you do have any Halloween cues that she can A, she will. But you also do have a skill that you can make anything Halloween. I'm hearing. You can make anything Halloween.
I can make anything Halloween.
Like if we throw you a celebrity, you could let us know how they are perfectly fitting for Halloween.
Is it just a celebrity or can we name anything and you can make it Halloween?
Like, do you want to name something or a celebrity or person and I link it back to Halloween?
Yeah, because I really want to make sure that everyone realizes there's no excuse to not have a bit of fun.
Everything is fucking Halloween and Jen Caruana can prove that theory.
Yeah, give me anything and I'll make it Halloween. Like I'll link it back to October 31st, Halloween.
I just want to call out Danielle who says, we've been crushing Airheads at the Monahan house. So that's great. And I am worried about your tongue, dude. Chill out.
Are Airheads those one that you put in your mouth and they go?
No, that's Pop Rocks.
Yeah.
Pop Rocks are sick, man. Put them in Sprite, see what happens. I don't know. I've never tried it, but I think it would sound cool.
Let's give Jan something to make Halloween. Anything.
Well, actually, we actually got a question. Best Halloween snack or finger food? What is it, Jan?
Oh, that's great. Well, you know what? And I'm going to shout out my girl, Jenny Cirillo, because I know she loves these too. I think if you're having a party, you can't go wrong with a deviled egg.
You can't go wrong with a deviled egg.
Here's the thing.
Thanksgiving, Easter
Christmas.
Opening it up at a new indoor or above ground pool. Yes,
you doesn't can't go matter.
Wrong with deviled eggs.
Deviled freaking eggs are it.
And it's in the name. It's in the name. Deviled eggs.
Oh, yeah. You know what you do?
Put a little pimento on them or something with little horns.
Yes, yes.
I would get little Thai chili peppers and cut them and just put them in there like that, like little two horns.
Yes. Oh, yes, Jason. Make them almost inedible. I love that about that. I love
If you don't think I'm down in that, no problem.
Do you not think that Jason's going to have his own deviled egg tray where it's like full of Thai chili seeds in and everyone's like, Jesus Christ.
You guys want some chips?
Roasted chips. Jesus Christ.
No, I can honestly say I don't want those.
Those are ridiculous.
But let's go. Let's connect something to Halloween because you can anything's Halloween.
Yeah.
Okay. A lawnmower.
A lawnmower. Okay. Here's the thing about a lawnmower. A lawnmower is okay. Do you want the fast version or do you want the walk?
I want you to take a walk.
Okay.
If you're asking Jason DeRoss, he's always going for walks.
All right. So a lawnmower is used to cut grass. Grass is something that you smoke. Like it's another name for marijuana. When you smoke marijuana, you get high. If you were to get high in an airplane, you would be going on a vacation. Chevy Chase was in the movie Vacation with Anthony Michael Hall, who was in Saturday Night Live as a cast member, as was Harry Shearer, who is also in all the Waiting for Guffman movies with Christopher Guest, who is married to Jamie Lee Curtis, who I believe was in Halloween.
She goddamn right was in Halloween.
Good, Jan.
You think it's not going to happen?
So you're going as Jamie Lee Cutgrass. I gotcha.
Jamie Lee Cutgrass.
Oh my God. Let's do another one.
How about this puka shell right here?
Can I just say, Jason kept before we went live, he goes, I just need a string to make this a necklace.
I couldn't find one. I even tried to improvise some stuff too, and it did not work. But I really wanted this puka shell necklace. And by puka shell, I mean conch. Full conch.
What's full conch?
You've gone full conch.
Bro, pukas are out. Full conch.
Dude, this podcast started as a wee little puka, and it's a fucking conch tonight.
Let me speak, because I got the conch, dude.
Jason, you have to keep that whenever you feel bullied on the podcast. You have to pull out your
Stacey. Quiet.
Okay, Jan, let's make this conch Halloween.
Okay, well, let's see. Conch, the most famous conch, as we all know, is from Lord of the Flies.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
A book that we all probably read at some point in grade 9. So in Lord of the Flies, it's a bunch of little kids and they're on an island. Another famous story about an island is Gilligan's Island, where they went away for a 3-hour tour. If you were to take the 3-hour and make that into 3 days, that is the long time that Jesus was in the tomb to be resurrected. The thing about Jesus is that he died and came back to life, just like a certain... a ghost named Patrick Swayze. Patrick Swayze was in the movie Dirty Dancing with Jerry Orbach, who was in Law and Order with Christopher Knopf, who was in Sex and the City with Sarah Jessica Parker, who looks like a skeleton. Where do you find a skeleton? Halloween.
Oh, yeah.
That was a tough one.
Okay. First of all, Elizabeth is really loving it. And obviously RIP. And Jan went.
RIP to Jesus or Swayze.
Exactly, Nigel. We don't know. Okay, so we're gonna keep having Jan do these walks. So please send us items, put it in the chat, and she will make anything Halloween. Now
we got another guest.
We do. Now here's the thing, everyone. We have a tarot card reading coming up, but right before that, we got a call. You know, we're a bit clairvoyant over here. And anyways, the dead are talking to us and we have someone with a lot of problems. So I wanted to introduce a disappointed ghost, everyone. Welcome.
Well, this ghost is really disappointed.
I'm sorry. I'm just disappointed.
What's going on, ghost?
Well, like I died, right? Like I'm dead. I've become dead. And I don't know if you know this, but when you become a ghost, you go to the afterlife and there's like this whole like long lineup. You go in this lineup and they give out your sheets that you put over your head so you can do ghost stuff.
Okay. Yep.
And so I was at the back of the line and everybody's ahead of me getting these sheets, white sheets. And then they ran out of white sheets. So they gave me a bedspread.
They gave me a bedspread and they said it's good enough.
You need to celebrate. What? So I'm stuck in this bedspread for the rest of my life now. Or my afterlife, I should say. Right. So it's just like not as scary, you know? It's like disappointing. So I'm disappointed. I'm a disappointed ghost.
Disappointed ghost. I'm actually extremely worried now because none of us are dead yet. But does that mean that they're out of white sheets and we're all going to have to get...
Well, that's the thing. You don't have to worry because they said they're getting a new shipment on Monday. I got assigned my sheet and there's no going backsies, they say. You can't... That's what no I am.
Backsies. So in heaven, saying backsies, no frontsies.
No going backsies in the ghost world. You can't just return your sheet. It's what you get. What you get is what you got.
Disappointed Ghost, I just want to ask you a few questions. Elizabeth wants to know, this seems to be Jason's bloodline. Is there a relation to Jason? Someone's also wondering, is this Jason's brother?
Yeah. Well, that's the thing. That's another scary. This is probably the only scary thing that I'll say. Jason, you're my dad.
What?
Whoa. You're my dad. I think he forgot the word son and then just said, you're my dad.
You're my son. Wait, no, you're my dad. Yeah. I like that better. That's scary.
I'm not
you
a virgin.
Another son. It's me.
I'm not a virgin.
But you still are though. I'm here to tell you that you still are a virgin. You had me in a weird way.
Oh, that you know turned that you into a ghost. Rumor?
Okay. Okay. Here's the thing.
I want to pull this thread. I'm into this.
How did Jason have sex in a weird way?
Yeah.
We have a plot twist, everyone. Weirdest Maury.
Also, you know what's really messed up? Snake King knows my actual brother's name somehow. So like the plot thickens.
Well, Snake King does know your brother's name.
Aaron?
Wait, we don't know, and we don't ask a lot of questions about Snake King because we do want to keep it a mystery, but that's a bit shocking.
That's a bit shocking for me.
Okay, I'm Disappointed Ghost. We just want to ask just a few quick questions. So when they gave you the sheet, did you decide not to put it over your full face? I mean, is there an option?
That's the other thing too that sucks so much. There's you also get assigned scissors to cut holes.
Wow.
For your eyes, and they ran out of those.
So now I'm just, you were assigned nothing.
Red spread and a plaid shirt that I die in.
I think
I just have to wear my bedspread without eye holes. I'll never get released to from ghostdom at this point.
Here's the thing: you're
forever
Disappointed Ghost. You're there for eternity. So, like, if I could tell you anything from my sheets. They start to like wear out a little bit. So eventually the pattern on that might wear out.
Oh my God. I do hope so.
And if you're there for eternity, who needs scissors? You could chew some eye holes into that.
Like a mouse.
Okay.
Like Stacy's mouse. Just chewing through her cupboards as we speak behind her.
Do you have any, Jan, do you have any questions for Disappointed Ghost?
I do have a question for Disappointed Ghost.
Yeah.
If they ran out of sheets, are you the only one who got a bedspread? Follow-up question. Mm-hmm. Do the plain white sheet ghosts make fun of the printies?
Ah.
Ooh. Oh, yeah. It's a real Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
They won't let you join any of the ghosty games?
But like with less of a happy ending for me, because no one's ever... What good am I ever going to be? You know, so I can't do anything with a patterned sheet. Like I can't lead a sleigh. It's not brighter than everyone else's nose or anything. It's just shitty.
I think it's unique. I fucking love it, to be honest.
Listen, that's your dad.
What? I love it. You what, when I die next week, I'm gonna come there and I'm gonna be like, I don't want your stupid sheets. I want a fucking duvet like my son.
Dad? You mean that, Dad?
Fuck yeah, I mean that. And I'll have sex with weird ways with all the ghosts up there, and we'll have a bunch of like duvet kids.
I've been waiting my whole life for you to say that. Just that you're proud
of me.
Your
life wasn't very long.
No, it's quite short. you age as a ghost as well.
Oh, you do age as a ghost?
Yeah. Yeah.
So how old did you start and how old are you now?
How old was I again, Dad, when I died?
Well, you were, it was a weird way. So like you were a tadpole is what we call it. You were a tadpole.
Yeah. Okay. I didn't, and then I sort of grew from there into a man, or into a boy. No, straight into a man. It was weird. Tadpole to man.
A frogman.
It's going to be a long afterlife.
Thank you, Disappointed Ghost.
See you in a week.
See you, Dad.
Oh, I accidentally removed him so much. Chris, thanks so much for being... Oh, okay, Chris is out of there. Chris Wilson from the Peter and Chris podcast. You can listen to his new podcast at Peter and Chris. His co-host is, I thought is solid content, but I thought he would be in the stream, but he's not. I might bring Chris on just to have a few choice words about, do you know that you're still on?
I'm still on. I like checked out. I'm just like,
okay, bye. Anyway, okay. That's fine. That's what I want from our guests from tonight. I just want them to check out and still be at the party. You know?
We've got our next guest is backstage and
This is exciting.
This is very exciting.
So our next guest, we know her, we love her. She's an MVP in the chat. And tonight she has given us a very special gift for Jason, and that is a tarot reading. So I'm going to do a little video for Jason because I found this cool tarot card gif and I wanted to use it. So with no further ado, we are going to bring on Jenny Cirillo for Tarot Time.
Oh. Oh, how nice.
Hello. How are you?
I'm great. How are you? I'm excited to go full conch today.
Oh my God, we've gone full conch today. You look gorgeous.
I love this headdress.
Thank you.
Okay, so
if you are listening to this, you are losing out. You need to jump to the YouTube right now, YouTube/TheRegulars, and check out this episode.
100%. So Jenny, thank you for coming on. You're going to read Jason's tarot. This is going to be amazing because Jason always says he's going to die, like he said already.
Yeah. Do I need to get out of the Scott for this? Do I need to like come?
No. I think I can figure it out.
Okay. What does he have to do? So you take over.
Okay.
Also, okay, welcome. So, hi, Jay. Thanks.
Are you excited?
Yeah. Incredibly.
Oh, it's on me. Okay. Cool. Okay. First, let's take a deep breath. Close your eyes. Everyone in the chat, let's all just like have a breath together. Three deep breaths.
Oh, I love this. Okay.
All right, Jason, you're going to ground yourself. You're going to get centered. Okay, one deep breath, one more. All right. Okay, so Jason, what do you know about tarot cards? Elizabeth, thank you.
What do I know about tarot cards?
What do you know about tarot cards? Have you ever had a tarot reading before?
Stacey has tried.
That's cool. That's nice. That's nice of your friend.
To be honest, I did have one back when I was in high school because a girlfriend took me for my birthday and it was scarily predictably, like in hindsight, it was scarily dead on.
I love it. That's great.
Which means I'm an open book, I guess. I don't know.
I mean, let's see what comes up. So like the way that I read is I'm going to pull a few cards. There's no rhyme or reason. I'm just going to flip a few things and see what comes up. And I read kind of intuitively. So we're going to see what the cards say. Feel free to like ask questions, jump in, say anything.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And so do you have like an area of life that you want to focus on, that you're interested in learning more about? Something that you,
let's talk about, career goal fulfillment. How about that?
Career goal fulfillment. Okay.
Yeah. I mean, like, that's why I've moved my life. I've done it. We were doing this. So, like, yeah, maybe that's a good way to go.
Okay, cool. So, like, maybe, like, what do we need to know to, like, really kind of reach our goals, right?
You got it.
All right, cool. So I just kind of, like, pull cards and see what comes up. You look excited, which I like.
Maybe my face isn't showing it. I said I was an open book, but I'm like... on the edge of my seat, literally on the edge of my seat.
He's freaking out. I'll leave you guys, but he was freaking out.
I'm good.
You're great. Okay, so I've just flipped a few cards, and we're going to see what comes up. Beautiful. Wow, okay.
This is like this feels like a doctor's appointment when they tell you bad news or something. This feels like right now.
No, this is actually wonderful news. I wish it was like a cooking show. You could see what comes up.
Wish my agent was here to hear this then.
Wow. Oh, me too. Give him a number. Is he single? Okay. So right off the bat, I want to say this looks really exciting and really positive. So when we're looking at like, what do we need to do to really like fulfill our goals? I'm going to say that you're kind of like well on your way. So we have We have the six of wands that comes up. This is like a guy on a horse, and he's like, there's a crowd around him being so excited. So there's a lot of like victory here, right? We've also got the Ace of Pentacles, and the Ace of Pentacles.
That's death card, right?
Okay, no, the death card would just be death, but the Ace of Pentacles is like a spark of like prosperity, opportunity, ooh, like just fucking giver, right? Whew, right? So I feel like you are on your way. We're like on this horse. You're like, you've got the crowd kind of cheering for you. It looks like there's-
Oh, you say that out loud and Stacey's gonna, yeah, okay.
What? What?
See, Jason, we're cheering for you.
We are cheering for you.
And you gotta do better.
Well, I mean, we'll see what the rest of the cards say. So we've got the hanging one. The hanging man is like this guy who's been flipped upside down, right?
Okay.
So it's a matter of like pausing. Like you are forced to pause. You are forced to shift a perspective. So we could kind of relate that to the pandemic in that like you have been forced to pause and maybe kind of like flip your perspective a little bit. I don't know if that kind of like hits.
Of course, we're all just sitting here as anxiety balls of yarn. Yeah,
we are, right? But I feel like there's a lot of like really great like movement and momentum kind of coming up within you, like deep within you. We've kind of got this like charge forward. I don't know if you are looking kind of like if you're weighing two options right now, if it's like A or B, or if there are like
which one do I choose? I'll label them A and B in my head right now. Do I choose A or do I choose B?
It's more just looking at like when you come to like work opportunities, it's like, I don't know if it's like A or B, stay or go, here or there, like right or left, whatever. It looks like there's a bit of a choice happening.
What do I pick? And, Jenny, you tell me what I pick.
Okay, well, we're going to pull some more cards to figure that out. Okay. I think that like there is a bit of like a leaving behind that
comes with A.
It. So I don't know if, okay, so we're going to go A. And it also is like an idea of like you... you feel the need to like defend where you've been and like defend what you've done and defend everything. But it's almost like there is like this urge.
Stacey's back like, just perked up. She knows exactly what you're talking about.
Oh, wonderful.
It has.
there might be like not an opportunity, but it's almost like, I wonder if there's a way to kind of like let go, move forward. And it's almost like you need to kind of make a decision in that. I'm just going to pull a few more cards here.
Is this normal? People get more and more cards as they go? Is that what they're thinking? Or are these leading like, oh, fuck, you're just messed up. So we got to keep going more cards and more cards.
No. This is what I do. I just kind of keep pulling until things kind of like keep going. I don't know. I think you're doing great. Are you feeling
okay? Thank you. Yes, this is all very, you know, anxious as hell.
Okay, let's take some more deep breaths.
Okay.
okay, so the devil comes up.
All right.
So it could be, I don't know if there, it is kind of spooky for Halloween, but I don't know if there's almost like this addiction to something or like...
Everything.
Addiction to everything, like, but almost like in a...
Thanks, Ace.
Like there's almost like this feeling of I almost wonder if you have been comfortable and like if you need to kind of like flip it and get uncomfortable. I don't know if that like I wonder if there's a bit more of like an idea of like pushing yourself. And there's also a bit of an idea of like learning a bit more. Eight of Pentacles is all about like mastery and apprenticeship. I wonder if there's something more about like, sorry, go ahead.
No, I was just saying ooh while you were talking. I entered myself in the chat because I just wanted to watch it.
I love it. Eight of Pentacles is all about like learning and mastery. So I don't know if there's, I wonder if there's like an opportunity that is like within this kind of like weighing and like within this kind of like new spark and this like new kind of like pursuit, if there's something that's like where you need to learn or like try something new or like really push yourself. I don't know. I feel like you've been really in your head about things a lot. You've been like really,
oh yeah,
thinking and
this
like
this is too real again. What's happening right now?
Jenny's amazing. Jenny is amazing.
And I'm gonna say that like there is kind of like this feeling of grieving, but like kind of like this guy is like sad, right? So there's this feeling of like grieving what is like in front of you or like. grieving what has fallen, grieving what hasn't like been bright. But remember that there's like these beautiful like cups behind you, right? Like there's this beautiful stuff that you've built and stuff that you've learned and stuff that you have like accomplished. So it's okay to look forward and be sad at like what you have lost, to fall to the ground and kind of be like, oh, I'm sad about things, but also remember like what's up in the back, right? And I feel like there is a new journey, you know? So I said like we had...
I just realized I'm taking notes, but I could just watch this podcast back later.
Yeah, youtube.com/theregulars.
Yeah, thank you. Stuck in his head. You said it.
I feel like there is a journey. So this is the moon card and the moon. So it is a full moon tomorrow. Great time to start thinking about like manifestation. This is the moon card and we've got this like little crab going on a journey. And you know when it is, you know when it's a full moon and you're like in the middle of nowhere, there's no like, it's all just like lit up by the moon and mm-hmm. things are, you can see shapes, but it's kind of strange.
Yep.
I feel like there's maybe a journey that is going to happen. So I keep talking about like moving forward, leaving something behind, like making a change. Mm. I feel like there's maybe something that's going to happen. And it's really like trust your intuition and things might feel strange and things like might, like you might be addicted to like the comfort, but there is a bit of like learning something new and like, I don't know, mastering.
This is telling me just stop drinking is what I'm seeing. But
oh my God. Oh my God. She's saying such amazing things.
I think she's saying a lot of amazing things. This is all great. I'm literally going to watch this back 18 times.
Elizabeth wants to know how to get cards read by Jenny. Just saying that we do have a giveaway. Jenny will be giving away a reading.
And Jenny, you do readings as well, right?
I do. Yeah. Yeah, I do. Yeah, you know, we've got the Six of Wands that's come up again. Like, I feel like there has been, like, all this conflict, and there's been this, like, curiosity on something, and there's been, like, this struggle. But I feel like, ultimately, with whatever you do, there is going to be, like, oh, look, okay, so there's going to be, like, it's a great... I think you need to, like... What is falling? Oh, okay. Interesting. Sorry.
No, we love.
By the way.
Is dropping the cards mean that my life... So what's happening now? Am I dead?
So you are going to die.
All of this was so real.
I feel like there's been a lot of like heartbreak. Maybe there's been some heartbreak. And maybe that's part of like that grieving, right?
Yeah.
I almost feel like you just... I don't want to say you need to make a decision, but I feel like you almost know the decision and like it's
Stacey, you look like you're in a John Hughes movie and you're just the supporting character going, oh, it's about to happen.
No, I'm loving this. I
know you are.
I feel this.
Is there like an opportunity for you to learn something new or go to school or yes. Yeah.
There is?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I feel like whatever that is, you kind of need to like pursue it. I don't know if it's another acting camp with bracelets or.
I love that acting camp.
I hope it's not.
I love it too.
What are you, can you share?
No. Because this is so personal. And this is crazy. I think that everybody should get their tarot done by Jenny, but I'm doing it in a very public thing where I'm supposed to be also being funny. So it's very weird to be
No. We wanted this to be like real and I'm loving this. Mm. Is there like one last card that we can pull? We don't want to like rush this amazing.
Sure. Yeah, no. So two cards came up and I just want to talk about it. So with regard to like this opportunity of like school or study or apprenticeship or mastery or something like that, we have the Empress that comes up and the Empress is really about like this. This card is very like maternal mothering. It's also like birthing something new, right? So I almost feel like it's like give yourself a hug, like kind of like this really nurturing heart, like nurture like a part of you. And something new will kind of birth from it. And the last card is the Six of Cups. And Six of Cups, look at this. We've got kids playing in a field. There's a giant cat. You know I love that.
Kid playing, not kids playing. Uh-oh, this could be bad. This could be bad news.
No. This is about like nostalgia, like getting back in touch with like that child within you, not even like the silly, goofy, whatever. What made you feel awesome when you were a kid and like really connect with that? So if it's going out, if it's playing in the sun, if it's whatever, then I feel like that's going to have to, that's going to.
I've been bathing in nostalgia lately.
Yeah.
Bathing in it.
I love it.
And that's not a joke. That's for real. It's been, I won't get into it, but.
Go for it though. You've got all like these, like, go for it.
Wait, is that a different card? Is that?
Sorry, I just keep pulling. I'm going to stop.
Is my life the whole deck of cards? Is that what it is? We're all living a whole deck of cards is what's happening.
Your life is the whole deck of cards.
That's amazing. No,
but I think that, yeah, I'll stop. But like, I think that like, if you're kind of going between these two choices, something that leads you down a road of like school or learning would be great. And I think it's a matter of just making the decision. Because whatever, when you make that decision, things will be victorious. Things will be good.
All right. Thank you. This is too, what am I supposed to do now? Like, I feel like that I need to virtually hug you, but I don't even know how to do that.
I know. This is so amazing.
That's okay. Thank you so much for having me on. Let's like have another deep breath together. Ready? I loved it. I hope you got something, Jay. And message me if you just want to chat about things later.
Oh, you my God.
In, you want to get in the above ground pool with us? Or?
Yeah, I mean, hell yes.
You know I do. Give me a Coors Light.
I will say Jenny did read my cards. I will be getting her to read my cards again. She is absolutely incredible. And you can follow her on Instagram. And is there anything else you would like to promote? You have an amazing events company. You have a wedding this weekend.
I do. I have a wedding. I'm a wedding and event planner in Toronto and worldwide. That's it. I like meeting new people. So just give me a shout if you want to chat.
Jenny's fabulous. We can't fabulous. Enough. And just thank you so much for coming on. Bye, Jenny. Thanks, Jenny. That was amazing.
That was too much, man. This is why I can't do these things. Now I feel inspired. I feel like this is why people should do these things, because now I feel like,
man, how are you?
I'm gonna go kick down doors. Let's go kick down some doors, you know?
Didn't that sit for you in the way that you think about Jason?
So much happened to me during that read. I know it wasn't my read, but I feel like a couple things. Every time Jenny was like, there's this conflict in your life, I'm like, that's Stacey. I'm like, this is bang on. It's like, there's this conflict in your life. And it keeps coming up. I'm like, yeah, every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday.
Oh my God, damn.
Money in the pool. But I feel like I've known Jenny since she was like a teen. Like, I've known Jenny for so long. And honestly, she is the best person. If you want an event, if you want a tarot card reading, if you want a deviled egg, if you want someone to talk to, like, Jenny is great. And I think like having your cards read by Jenny is like so much more probably than like just having your cards read by some stranger. Cause I feel like she's like so empathetic.
Oh, she's wonderful.
Yeah. I mean, like I'm literally blown away, and like, we are going to give away a reading tonight, but also like reach out to her and get your get read. That's sick.
Yeah, get read. So we will link everything below and it should be there. If not, I will be adding it. Thank you, Jenny, so much. Now, like, because we're getting spookier and spookier and spookier. So now we have this next guest. You know him, you love him. It's Mr. Conspiracy.
Do you want to? I know, totally. We do have a guest, but do you want to throw out? We have one more video first.
Of course.
One more video before we jump into our next awesome guest.
Okay, and this is, we know him, we love him. He needs but no introduction. I'm sure right now he's eating an apple opposed to a Hershey's bar, and he's staying at a hotel for free. And this is a spooky story told to you by the wonderful Adam Colley.
Okay, so my story starts in Pickering, Ontario, Canada. I was in an acting class when I was like 12 to 14, I don't remember exactly, but I was with a bunch of older people and I got invited to this like punk girl, the cool girl in the class, her Halloween party. It was like in the sticks, it was like a backyard party, Halloween, great. I never dressed up that much as a kid, so I didn't have a lot of stuff. So I put on, I had like a weird Phantom of the Opera kind of mask, and I just had black and white clothing. So like black pants, a black shirt, and a white vest with this white mask. And I was really nervous because I was young, and the girl was probably like 18. So I show up to her house, No one wearing costumes. There's like 24 huge dudes drinking Pabst Blue Ribbon, being like, it's Halloween, let's get fucked up. And I'm like, why am I wearing a costume? It's a Halloween party. You should specify when there's a costume and when there's not a costume. So very quickly, I whip off the mask, and now I'm just wearing a white vest and a black shirt. And some guy comes up to me, and he's like, hey, like, you party? And for some reason, the black t-shirt I had under or on the back had a red A, which was like the anarchy symbol, which was like a thing that other people were wearing. I was like, yeah, look. And he was like, rock on, man. I had never drank a beer in my life. Didn't even that night. So I'm petrified. I'm walking around this bonfire with people like crashing beers on their head. Then the really funny woman from our acting class shows up, and she's in a massive clock costume. A massive red clock costume. There's nothing she can do. She's going to be there for hours. And she showed me what it's like to have confidence. She was like, fuck it, I'm a clock. I'm going to be the funniest clock in the whole party. And everyone loved her. And it was a Halloween party where I was reminded that every party I go to from now on, I have to ask, we dressing up or are we partying? Happy birthday, regulars.
If he had confidence, did he put the fucking Phantom of the Opera mask back on? We'll never know. He didn't, though. I guarantee you he did not.
Well, I want to say that I love that he was like, I guess it was like an anarchist t-shirt. I had never drank a beer. And I also didn't that night.
No,
but also, funny. Adam and I grew up in the same city. So guess what? I was probably at that party. When he said smashing bottles over there, I was like, yeah, who's the little kid here with the Phantom of the Opera mask? Pretty cool.
The funniest part of that story to me is that I've known Adam for probably like 15 years. I don't think I've ever seen him in a t-shirt.
No.
Yeah.
No. He looked amazing. That ring light, Adam, please tell me what ring light that is, because you looked amazing. He really
did. That's his self-tape sort of room.
Okay, so I did want to, like, first of all, I would like to keep unpacking the tarot reading. I am getting a lot of personal reach outs from friends who are watching this that said, Jan got you really good, and multiple people have said that. She's not wrong. She wasn't wrong. But so we'll keep unpacking that. But I thought we could switch into
Dan, 20 points.
To our lovely pal, Mr. Conspiracy, Alex Kalenko, who's going to regale us with some spooky conspiracies.
Yeah, I cannot wait.
I know, me too. Alex, welcome.
Yay. Yay. Hello.
Alex, it's been so long.
It's been a while. I know it's been a while. I've just been depressed. I don't know the real answer. I reached for something and just went with the truth.
I will say you have very cottage core vibes behind you. And
yeah, I live with my girlfriend. So a white woman put plants everywhere is the real answer.
But I want to say, like, I know that you work at a bank and you're a tech man. And I just love this. It's the webcam is an improvement. It looks way better.
Yeah, that computer died.
Okay. So we've been really like Jimmy Jazz Dorino'd about you coming on and getting and freaking us out with conspiracies.
Yeah. So you asked me for a spooky conspiracy, and the stuff that I've been reading recently, I would argue, is not spooky. It's like, how is QAnon proliferating at such a rate? What's happening in Bolivia? Aren't really spooky. But I want to get a spooky one for Halloween. So I went and looked in a place I don't normally like of alien conspiracies.
Ooh.
But I found the one, I got the one that I do really like.
Okay.
And this starts scary and then gets weird and sad. And it gets
Does it have to do
weird.
With Mitch McConnell's hand?
A little, actually. there's a parallel I could draw. So there's the Men in Black. That is what we're going to talk about, but not the Will Smith vehicle.
Oh damn!
Factors in, in a weird way. So the Men in Black are a type of alien, supposedly. Who knows?
What?
So the original, Men in Black, the movie, is based on this comic book that's based on this history of ufology. I use too many air quotes for this, but I don't believe in aliens. I believe they're real. I don't believe they come visit and hang out.
Okay. Agree to disagree.
So the Men in Black are either government body, like CIA people, who protect aliens, who show up when there's alien stuff and threaten you, or they're aliens who are trying to look as human as possible and keep the secrets that aliens are around and trying to control us. So the beginning of it is, I believe, Albert K. Bender, who is an airline pilot in World War II, who claimed to have seen UFOs and then was visited by these men in black who then threatened him. And then he wrote a book about it. What I'm gonna have to do on this is that with conspiracy theory stuff, everyone's trying to hawk you something. Like, everyone's trying to sell you something of right. whatever that is, whether it be a political ideology or their book. Most cases, it's the second. In the case of Alex Jones, it's like supplements. But everyone's trying to sell you something. So keep that in mind when I say this. So he wrote a book.
So is Alex Bender trying to sell us something?
He's trying to sell you his book. And so this is like in the 1920s. I think the book came out in 1940-something. I look it up. Who cares?
If it's on Audible, I'm getting it.
If it's on paper, forget about it. But if there's someone fucking telling me it, I'll sign up.
James is like, I have one credit.
I got two. Ready to go.
So at the time in like the early early half of the century, there was kind of the beginning of like ufology. Like now we consider ufology or UFOs or alien people as like kind of cranks who kind of like get together and crank out together online. But at the time it was like there was no internet. There was barely the media that was shipped around was very small. A lot of it was experimental spacecrafts that were covered up by the CIA. And so there was like, it was a little more of a a little more of like a common thing. So a lot of magazines and a lot of groups that required money or asked their people to give them money to do this. So he was also hawking his group by making this book. Mm-hmm. Either way, later on, unrelated to him would be this guy, Gray Barker. So Barker and Bender are the kind of the two people who created this. And Barker really solidified it. Like he wrote a book called They Knew Too Much About Flying Saucers in the 1956, I think.
Spooky time. 50s is really spooky.
Yeah. Plus, you really spoiled this with like starting with aliens aren't real, because I'm on this. I'm ready to believe.
I know. Here's the thing. No, it's going to buy it.
Ready to believe.
Go farther. The reason I kind of skipped through Bender and got to Baker is because Baker, I think, like all the modern versions of it are kind of based on his. So his book is mostly like about just basically a series of stories of people who've experienced Men in Black, or a book later. But either way, it's like he gives a story that's very specific about the Men in Black, and then claims to have been followed by them for the next 10 years and smells sulfur and has all these interactions with them.
Wait, now, so Men in Black smell like sulfur? Like fart?
So let me stop and describe what the modern version of it. So it's
like either, you know the stream you're on, right?
Yeah.
you had a scrambling at ufology where I was like, what the fuck?
Like ufology.
Because sulfur smells like farts smell like sulfur, right? So it's like
Jason and I are ruining this, but that's just
No, there's truth though. Like if I'm in an elevator, I'm like, ooh, no, it's just the aliens, guys, just the aliens.
It's a little like the alien stuff is hard to explain because it just bounces around and everyone's contradicting each other, and it's really hard to like nail down it. But the modern version of Men in Black, I think a very good story of it is like they describe that they have no joints.
Ew.
So it's like it's tall, thin, white dudes in black suits.
Remember when I told, maybe I didn't tell you, but I kept seeing that at the foot of my bed. And then when I got my, I had a Reiki session and someone described a tall, lanky man, white man in a suit. And she was like, that's your spirit guide. Is my fucking spirit guide a Men in Black ghost?
So I was going to get into it later about the kind of collective hallucination of Men in Black.
Come to me. Like
if you go through history, through history of like demons, through history of witchcraft, through history of pick your poison through the years, there's always some sort of entity that is a tall, thin man the more common, I think the most recent version of it would be like Slender Man.
Alistair Farr. Yeah.
Or me.
this is why you're telling us. You don't suspect the person that tells you the truth. I gotcha.
Yeah.
don't worry, guys. Just the aliens.
Am I going to get visited by Men in Black tonight for calling you out for being a Men in Black?
Well, man, we're jumping around. But
sorry. We asked you to come in with something.
It's okay. Again, like alien shit is just going to be, it's going to be a bunch of jumping around, and I'm sorry.
We apologize. I love it. Too. We stopped on farts, and is that my spirit guide? I mean, the here isn't it a goddamn wonder?
Correct. Like none of it, like, this is all bullshit. Like, none of, like, just, who cares? Let's have fun.
oh my God.
I'm not sure if it's being depressed. So like a modern Men in Black, no joints. So it's supposed to be very strong, and they, like, they act like being human. And I've heard the term high strangeness. I've heard the term surreal people, of that, like, things go unusually around them. So supposedly you're supposed to act different, of like, if they'll, you'll be more willing to give them personal information. You'll let them into your house easier. The most, like, the two most famous Men in Black stories you'll find is one of this very famous, like, kind of like precursor to Alex Jones guy in the alien world called, starts with an H, Hopkins. And so he supposedly was visited by a Men in Black who, he's interviewing him about, like, the first abductees, asking, like, do you know how they died? Do you know the stuff about them? Because he had, like, done something on the radio about them. Yeah. And then he told him to pull a coin out of his pocket, like, knowing that he had this specific coin in his pocket. He pulls it out and then makes it float, and he describes it as like a great heat into his eyes. And then he threatens that if he continues this, he'll do it to his heart. And then he does it to him for a little to prove it. And then he basically leaves. And the guy's like, what the fuck was that? The other more common one, and this is, like, I think, like, the ground zero for a lot of these. Yes, the lipstick. Yeah, exactly. The ground zero for a lot of this one is that, I'm totally blanking on the person whose story it is, but it's from, like, the major Men in Black book, which is a collection of stories. And he comes, and this guy gets invited in. He's very inhuman. He starts looking on closer, realizes he has no fingernails or no joints. Also, he's, like, super pale, has no hair. And then he notices he has these, like, bright red lips. And then he realizes it's just a hole in his face. Lipstick on.
I cannot. So he looks like
a human.
I want to see this guy's Tinder profile.
Oh, it's great. It's,
I'm sweating. Thank
looking
God
for I'm a partner in crime.
Ew, yeah. This sounds really freaking gross. It also sounds like some loser improv coach we've all been taught by or something.
Yeah. You enter the room, just talk about the smell of the room. Just talk about the smell.
Supposedly they have, like, very, like they don't, they describe it as speaking with an accent that they can't place. It's like a non-accent. And they seem, and, like, for example, like, there's that particular one with the lipstick, I believe he's, like, confused by a door. And it's like, well, you came in through a door, and he doesn't quite understand. He also leaves very suddenly and starts to, like, lose strength as if he's, like, disappearing.
Can I say something pretty dumb? So, yes. Okay. So when we think of, like, ghosts, we're just like, you know, like, we had the disappointed ghost, bit of a sheet situation. Ooh, I'm your grandma, you know, your mom's, you know, a bitch who just came back to tell you. But the Men in Black kind of ghosts sound like the ghosts that are just, like, no chill. They still think they're alive. Like, I mean, it's like,
they're not ghosts, are they?
No, but they seem pretty obvious that they're, like, they're not low key. They're like,
so here's my two points on that. Is one is that, as far as, like, like aliens and ghosts and whatever, they're the ones with a clear goal, and their goal is through you. And their goal is to make sure you don't talk about aliens, make sure you hide aliens, make sure you don't.
It's a Fight Club situation.
Yeah, their goal is secrets. Their goal is either keep or maintain secrets. Great. Now, your second point of being like ghosts and aliens, and you're lumping it all together as a thing, is that gets to the part that more interests me about this, of the idea of a collective hallucination, sometimes called TULPA. Of being like TULPA, being that it's an entity or a thought form that we have created. So we just did tarot cards. So we're going to get into occult shit. So occult magic and ritual magic is the idea that you're taught through science and common religion that the world existed, and then you and your consciousness were put on top of it. right? So like, there's a physical world, and then you get in your consciousness into there, right? Yeah. So occult magic is under the understanding that you can't really prove that. And what if it's your mind existed, and then you created this physical world, and that you're the experience of this physical world.
This is Jason, all affected by it. This is Jason's full MO because he's all Truman Show all the time.
You're all living in my world.
Yeah, he so, thinks it's a simulation.
I'm in a simulation where I control the world and I just make people shit on me. Like that's
yeah, man, I really fucked up my simulation. We're like, how am I this broke in my own simulation?
Yeah, I mean, if I were to look at my simulation, I want a refund, certainly. I'm wearing a bathing suit top alone in my apartment. It doesn't fit. I can tell you guys that.
But you got a mock turtleneck underneath. That's that. That writes itself.
So the idea being that how to explain this easily. Okay, you know, like Pepe the Frog, and people are like, they posted enough fucking Pepe the Frogs and that Donald Trump got elected. So that's the idea that like enough people created an idea to create something real. Now you can be like, well, it wasn't the frogs, it was people voting, disenfranchised voters, like, but isn't like if it was real magic, it would look like that. Like it would look like that, right? And if it was real magic, that's what it would look like. So the other idea being like the common phrase is, in modern day shit is like before the atomic bomb was a bomb, it was an idea. So they had this idea of splitting the atom and creating nuclear fission. And then how did it become the bomb? Because the idea of wanting to hurt people, the idea of wanting to create a military complex. So this all comes
together. Is our bombs conspiracies?
No, bombs are real.
You have to understand that you're giving Jason the permission to yell, "This is a simulation" at most in his life.
That's what I'm getting into. So the idea is that if enough people believe in something, or you believe in something hard enough, that is the beginning of the beginning of like creating something. So a tulpa is an idea that is fed on something. So the guy I was talking about, Great Baker, was probably a schizophrenic, probably had a manic depressive disorder, had a series of strokes.
He partied. Okay.
He lived with his stepdad and was alone most of his life.
Okay.
Until he got a wife and then like kind of dropped all this stuff. But he really pushed this idea of a Men in Black, and then eventually, quote unquote, like ran into one and met one. So this is at a time where the CIA was investigating a lot of these ufologists, people who were studying UFOs, because if we talk like the early 50s of US, I love topical stories, thanks. The 1950s was like, and 40s with UFOs was a lot of experimental spacecrafts the CIA was trying to cover up with this idea of UFOs. It's that they were disseminating a lot of UFO information. But that also meant that CIA agents were like following these people to make sure they weren't like communists or Russian infiltrators or whatever. And so this is a guy who maybe wasn't quite in our reality, who saw, was followed by CIA agents and had tied it to this alien theories he already had, creating this idea of a Men in Black. And then he created it so hard.
He was so happy that day. He's like, oh, they're following me. It's happening.
Isn't it crazy what people did without the internet? It was like the 50s. They're like, I think I'm being followed. It's probably an alien. And
in the 50s, a lot of people were followed by the CIA. Like in the 50s and 60s, we're getting to the conspiracy sides that I care a lot about. It's just people being followed by the CIA for
That's what I was going to say. Like the 50s was everyone, like women not having rights and just men getting followed around by the CIA for whatever.
They love to follow. So the idea is that he created this idea of a Men in Black that now exists in the physical world of other people who believe in it, and enough people believe in it to create it real, to manifest it in our world, in this idea of an occult world. That's a high, like someone mentioned they love tulpa stories. I realize I am incredibly simplifying the idea of tulpa and also merging it a little bit with like occult theology, but do you really want to get into it?
Well, I mean, the vibe.
Going to follow me on that one?
No, I thought that you were like, I really simplified it. And I was like, great, because the chat's going, yeah, man, wine before beer, you're in. we're having a party time.
This is amazing, though. Now I'm going to look into this type of stuff, I think, because.
Yeah, it gets a little more complicated, a little bit more about like
And then I'm out.
A little bit more about like the idea that like it plays into your simulation thing. And so then we start getting into this idea of like arm men in black. So there's a few things of it, of whether it is a manifestation that created a mistrust in the government.
Yes.
From people who already mistrusted the government. Is it this thing in the back of our subconscious of a thing we naturally fear, of a long, thin man that has existed through years and years and years of our life, of whether it be like, there's like versions of like witchcraft, especially like in 1800s Scotland, there's a lot of reports of seeing cloaked, long, thin figures in the fields doing rituals.
They get dates. They're good.
The Salem witch trials had a lot of references to long, thin people that were supposedly driving the witches, that were controlling the witches.
See, this makes sense because I've always said, based on my present day karma, I'm pretty sure I was a witch during the Salem witch trials. And this fucking makes sense that my spirit guide would be a tall fucking white guy who probably burnt me at the stake. And he's still fucking walking around the world with me. And I literally cannot, Devin, if that's your name.
Yeah, it also scares me because like I know that it's real because I'm scared of volleyball games, like beach volleyball games.
Shut up, Jesus. Dan, do you have any questions about the Men in Black?
This idea of a tall, thin man, like a tube man, is terrifying. Like that is just something that like gets inside your head, and that's like an image you can't erase.
100%. I'm 6'3" and under 200 pounds. So like, way to just fucking shout me out like that.
Oh, please. No. I'm not imagining you. I'm imagining someone with very long fingers. Yes. You know Alistair who I'm Force. Imagining.
And also, Kalanko, every time he's on this podcast, he gets a lot of thirsty ass messages for which I've never gotten a single one. Okay, so he is like, oh, am I so scared? Please. Please.
It's fun to make fun of me. I'm an easy target.
I'm so cute.
Try being a 5'3" boy.
Oh, and you've been fine too. Jace, we've all seen you after a comedy show. No offense, Jenny. I know you're happily married, but women being like, you're so funny, Gina. And I'm like, I was in the show too, you know. Like, I don't remember you. I don't actually remember you.
Yeah, the other one, the one little story that I would like, that I think, like one that I just thought was very interesting, of like in the strangeness of it, is that supposedly like they're not very good at walking, the men in black are not
good at walking. They sound like they fucking suck, honestly.
and that one walked and like kind of tripped and like steadied himself on like just kind of like a you know, like steady, like just like touch the wall kind of steady thing on like a file cabinet, and then left indents into the file cabinet because he'd hit it so hard and so strong that they're just so much stronger by this jointless, thin, noodly fingers.
I hate this.
I'll say this. Next time I'm like on a subway platform or something and I see a tall guy stumble, I'm going to be like, oh, no. Get him.
Men in black. Oh, what do you want to do because you're outside, buddy? Where's your lipstick? Where's your lipstick in your mouth?
And then I mentioned at the beginning of how the movie plays into it. So there's two major theories about the movie. So if you read about Men in Black and like how it ties into the great collective nightmare that we created, the idea of the movie is that it's either a plot by the Men in Black to create misinformation to make you trust people in suits again, or it is a plot by people in the want for good who are trying to create a different version of Men in Black, trying to change the idea of the Tulpa and change the idea of it so that it's now a, like, instead of feeding off fear and feeding off of making us uncomfortable, it's now feeding off of like a fun idea and like it's a protectorate of us. I think it's very interesting.
I just think it's crazy they would use the movie with Will
Tommy
Smith
Lee Jones. And
Tommy Lee Jones to make people trust
the tallest, thinnest man in Hollywood.
Because it's based on this like comic book, and the comic book is based on like these stories, and it's like you kind of watch the villain. It's like five issues total, I think. And each issue is like someone knows something about aliens, and you watch these two guys destroy his whole entire life for 22 pages. That is the comic book. And they're like,
can I get that on Audible?
this is a movie. I don't know if you want to read a comic book on Audible, just like having someone being like, this next panel, a man is standing near a fork. Like,
I'm in.
Well, Kaleko, I want to thank you for coming on and teaching us about the scariest thing I've ever heard in my entire freaking life. Where can people follow you?
You can follow me at Alex Kaleko on Twitter, or you can listen to other podcasts I'm on where randomly I'll just go on these kind of jaunts because neither of them have anything to do with this. Shush, I'm watching a movie. SHH, I'm watching a movie where I watch a whole movie with Alessandro Vite, or Bummer Boys, X Bummer, X Bump. X-Bummer, X-Boys, X, styled like a bad hardcore band, where we talk about punk music and songs that make you sad.
Yeah.
And we'll put all
the links below. So follow Kaleko. Thank you so much for coming on, and I'll never sleep again. Thanks,
Alex. Yeah. Oh my God, he's the best.
Okay. Guys, no thank you to that. A lot of people are, not.
I mean, thanks to Alex. That was great information.
That was huge. That was, No joint thing is what got me. I remember convincing my dad to get me a hamster, and I held it once, and I said, get rid of it. I don't want this thing. It doesn't have a spine.
But no joints, like even in the shoulders or the hips, because then you just can't move. You just have to stand there like a stick.
Ugh,
no, it's like those tube guys. Like they're just too wiggly.
Oh, they don't have joints, so they're just like jellyfish. Okay.
Yeah, so they're just like,
Alex is for sure just going, no.
No, wrong.
Okay, so now we are... okay, so who we have now is major friend of the pod, who is, well, I'll just
double him. Major friend of the pod.
Double major friend of the pod. And I'm really excited because we have an adventure, and we will let them explain what's happening. But guys, give it up for Dungeon Master Siddiqui.
Halloween spookulars.
How are you?
Oh, I am filled with piss and
me too.
Brimstone.
We didn't take in washroom breaks on this. We didn't take into consideration washroom breaks. So me too.
Yes.
Good. Holding in your bladder urinary tract infection is the scariest thing this Halloween. I hope that's cranberry juice in your bottle, Jason DeRoz.
Bottle's empty, buddy.
UTIs for everybody.
No. I'm going to make trades with my brother.
I've got hair in my mouth. My own hair grows.
Dungeon Master Siddiqui, what do you have planned for us today?
Oh, my word, my friends. You are joining a dear friend of mine. And you guys are going to have a little adventure.
Ooh.
A creepy, spooky adventure.
Ooh.
Yes, this adventure takes place.
He's very, your friend is very dark.
Creepy, spooky. I wonder why I'm dark. Can you hear me?
we can hear you, friend, but have you connected?
your camera on?
It says my camera is on.
You got to move the
top cam, start cam.
Okay.
Turn the lights on, Jane.
Hey, Google, start camera.
This is okay. This is a fine time to figure it out because Tamika's got to charge her crystals and come to figure this out. Jay?
Yeah, I'm trying to see if my thing got disconnected. Maybe.
Oh, technical problems nearing the end of the show is the scariest thing.
No, this tracks. This is what we need. We need this right now, and that's okay. Dungeon Master, why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself while we're waiting?
Well, I've been a Dungeon Master for 100 years. Ooh. I live up at DuPont and Christie. And I constantly eat at Vesta Lunch. I also buy the most expensive avocados at the Loblaws and return them after throwing them against the wall. Yes.
That's amazing. Also what?
I have a fistula.
Yes. Yes.
We all know what a fistula is.
We all know.
Stacy's so mouse, do you know what a fistula is? Do you have your suppository in?
Stop asking me that.
Yes, fair enough.
You know, while we're waiting for Jay to sort out his camera, you know, I thought what we could do is do another walk with Jan. And so, Dungeon Master, do you have something that's the opposite of Halloween that my mouse in my house could make festive and Halloween vibey?
Ooh, yes.
Ooh.
The most perfect un-Halloween thing. Hanukkah.
Very Halloween-y.
Okay. Can you do it? Are you ready?
Yeah.
She's done it before.
Hanukkah is the celebration of light. So the candles burned on very little oil for 7 days and seven nights. What else lasts for 7 days and seven nights? An all-inclusive vacation to Cuba. when you go to Cuba, everybody's very concerned that you only drink bottled water. To get bottled water here, we've eschewed bottled water, and we say that you should get Brita. Brita was a character in a television show called Community, starring what's that guy's name? McHale?
Joel McHale.
From The Soup. Soup is something that you eat when it's chilly outside. When does it get chilly? The fall. Fall is in October. October is Halloween.
What? The actual?
Oh, what did you think of that, Jebediah? This is my dog.
I mean, it kind of looks like a real skeleton of a real dog. I mean, I wouldn't believe it.
Check it out.
Ooh.
Oh, I thought those were overlays, but shit. They're actually physically
turn
in your
off.
Place.
Listen, Shayla said that she's loving this. Rochelle says, Jan, you are a treasure.
That's always the right word right now and her adjective to use for Jan.
Is what?
Treasure.
An absolute goddamn treasure. Dungeon Master, is there any word from our dear friend?
He keeps saying, I'm not in. Am I not in? He's saying.
Am I not? Oh.
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 We have somebody popping in backstage.
It does say.
Oh.
All right.
Yeah.
Phone to the rescue.
Are you on your phone?
Now I am.
Can we just point out that Jay McCarroll is a very tall, slender white man. So
gorgeous, gorgeous man.
But he's men in black.
Great. Yeah. Oh, you look great.
Oh, thank you, Stace.
You know, no problem. Oh, he's
Make it work.
This is perfect. This is what we want. You there know what I mean? Jay, how are you? We've missed you so much.
I'm good. Oh, you're not even coming out of my earphones anymore. Okay. I'm great.
Take a breath. You're here. And you know what? It's rude. I didn't even give you a second to settle in. Your face popped in and I joined you right into the chat. But you're here. We're so happy.
And now we're here and we're settled and we're having fun. Jan is a pleasant surprise to see here too.
Hi, Jay.
This is going exactly as planned.
This is such a spooky setup.
I will tell you, I think there's just something in the air because Mercury is in retrograde. So we do this podcast 3 times a week. And today I sat down, I was like, no problem. I've got this dumb fucking wig on. And my camera didn't work. And my mic didn't work. And I was under my desk with my
also
dog.
Also, your neighbor started blaring music for the first time ever.
Ever. And I was just like, this is so classic. But anyways, we're excited. So now Dungeon Master.
Yeah.
Are you ready?
Our question is, are you ready?
Yes!
Then we shall turn our eyes to the evening that the three of you characters are spending in a spooky cabin in the woods.
Ooh.
We will go back in time. The year is 1992.
Sick.
I believe Demolition Man is about to play in theaters.
Okay.
And Batman Returns has just come out.
Fuck
and
yeah.
You three are to... Jen, you want to play with us?
Sure.
Yes. Oh,
yes.
You four high school students on a dare from each other. All four of you dared each other to spend one night in a haunted cabin.
Ooh.
Because all of your previous Halloweens have not been scary enough.
Oh, okay.
Right. You wake up in a spooky, scary cabin that looks like its construction is made out of old wet wood and duct tape. It's a very poorly built cabin. But there, four of you are, and all four of you are very stereotypical teenagers in high school.
Okay.
So why don't one by one you introduce yourselves to the audience?
Oh, amazing. Okay, I'll go first. My name is Chrissy. I'm freaking horny as hell. My dad thinks I'm at my friend Amanda's house, and I'm absolutely not. Yes. My main objective this weekend is to just get sexually nuts.
Yes. Who is next?
I can tell you.
All right. I'll go next. I'll tell you that this guy right here, his name is Fred. This is Fred. I'm president of the football team. That's what I call myself.
President.
Football team.
It is an elected position.
Yeah, right. Yep.
Okay.
Also president of the rugby team. I throw so many touchdowns and playoffs, get so much sex, I'm bored of it. I'm doing this dare, it's going to be the easiest thing I've ever done.
Fred, is it safe to say that your boner is literally a bone?
Can't keep this boner down.
Oh, all right. And who do we have next? You, the man with the bare shoulders.
Hi, I'm Philbert. And I just came from hosting a coding camp.
Philbert. You sound like a loser, Philbert.
No. I haven't had done much in the romantic zones because I'm saving myself. But I do work at a deli counter at a Ralph's. So if you ever need some cakes done, I'm really innovative with that stuff.
Oh, fantastic. Thank you so much. And now finally, our last guest, what is your name and who, what stereotypical role do you play in your high school?
My name is Colleen. And the only reason I'm here is because I'm writing about this for the school newspaper.
Yes. You're also on the yearbook committee, are you not, Colleen?
Yeah, I'm in charge of superlatives.
A very important position. Now, all four of you have made your way to this cabin in these woods, and you have just woken up. This is your first time experiencing. As you open your eyes, you look around and you see your surroundings.
Oh, wow. This cabin's like pretty hot, no?
Yes. Actually, Chrissy, can you throw up the first picture?
I can, absolutely.
Oh, goodness. This is the cabin that you awake. As you can see, it needs a bit of tidying in the front. But... Can you put up the second picture now, Chrissy?
Mm.
Yes. There, see, you are inside this cabin. As you can see, there is a bedroom and quite a small living room. This is what we call a bachelor apartment.
A bachelor apartment.
Now you all wake up. And you are seeing that it is, once again, you 4 in this gloomy Halloween, trying to scare yourselves. How groggy are each of you?
Well, I had like a couple sips of a White Claw, so I'm definitely feeling something.
Oh, yes. Good, good. Actually, yes. How you are so drunk. Chrissy, why don't you roll me a dice and tell me what your result is? Roll me a D20.
Ooh, I'm doing that like right now.
Oh, good.
I have the dice just so everyone knows if you need me to roll it for you.
Oh, perfect. What a nerd!
You gave me the link. Yes. Okay, so I roll, what is it, the 20? D20, okay. I got 17.
Oh, you are pretty wasted.
Oh my God.
Actually, a lot of people can, all the rest of them can see a side boob.
Oh my God. Take it in, take some snaps, use flash. I didn't bring it out for nothing.
Oh, good. What about you, Philbert? How do you feel?
I feel pretty good. I tried a new thing called Azima because I'm in clear. It's clear beer, pretty popular here in 1992. And I felt like I was, you know, I didn't plan to wake up here next to Chrissy. Maybe we did something. I don't know. Do I have to throw my ring out? Do we maybe?
Yes, you do. You have to throw it out right now. Roll me a D20 to see how far your ring goes.
He rolled a 10.
Okay.
A 10.
I rolled a half, yeah, a half a 20.
Oh, it hits the window and bounces back and hits you in the knee.
Oh, fuck.
Fred, what about you, young man? You're waking up. What do you see?
Ugh. Well, Fred's going to kind of hide his hangover a little bit. But then he gets up and he stretches and he looks around, kind of paces around the room and says, well, I'm going to go check the fridge if there's any more White Claws in there. Might as well get started early. And I try to kick the door open, like, really, really athletically.
Oh, yes. Roll me a D20. Let's see how much you kick that door open.
Okay. It is a 8.
8. You kick it so hard, but your foot twists in the middle of the kick, and you break your baby toe.
Oh, no.
That's no problem.
Also, there is no White Claw left. Chrissy drank it all.
Sorry.
Colleen, you are coming to your senses. What do you feel?
Well, I'm really happy that I snagged a spot on the sofa under this Afghan that smells like mildew.
Yes.
And I'm looking around and I'm just like, could this place be any more stereotypical?
It's true, but there's something wrong with that Afghan. Roll me a D20 to see what is wrong with that Afghan.
She rolled a 6.
Oh, that Afghan is covered in polio. You now have the early onset. So you have early onset polio, Colleen.
I'm the one who drove up here. How are we going to get
this? Wait a second. Does she know she has polio?
We will see.
Also, we drove up here together. This is what are we? This is great.
Yeah, we're a real eclectic bunch, you know. Like, I love our gang, you know.
I love our gang.
Yes, and you go out to check it, to see out the window if your car is still there, Colleen. But unfortunately, your Saturn is gone.
Hey, Colleen. Colleen, where's your Saturn?
I don't know, guys. I parked it right under that tree with the hollow log.
Seems good as place as any.
I don't know.
Let's go check it out. Fred kicks open the door and walks out towards the tree.
All right, before you kick another door, roll a D20 for me, Fred, to kick another door.
This time will be different, guys. It's a 9.
You use the same foot as the first time and break the toe immediately to the left of your baby toe.
Oh, that other toe. I mean,
this is This is ridiculous. I'm going to use my really big cell phone and I'm going to call my dad and he's going to get us out of this mess.
Oh, let's see how many bars you have. Roll a D. Oh, fucking five. No, a D6. You have a D6 there. Let's see how many bars you get on your phone.
I have a 6.
Shit, that's the worst roll. No one ever wants to roll a 6 with a D6. You have no bars on your phone. And it's out of batteries.
Shit.
You guys, we said, remember, no cell phones because it's not scary enough.
Fine.
We can do this.
What about this nerd?
I got an AM radio.
Yes, that's right.
Let me see if I can see what pops up on this ham radio. I just got to climb up onto the roof.
Yeah. Oh, yes. Let's see how much you can climb. Roll me a D20.
But my knee from the ring. Remember?
Yes. How much is your...
He rolled an 18.
Ooh.
Thank God.
Ooh, like a monkey from India. You scamper up the side of the cabin.
Show off.
And you see, you look down. Never before has a nerd like Filbert been this high to look down upon the cool kids in school.
Now I'm the leader.
We can see your underwear through your shorts.
Oh, fuck.
It's yes, my EP underwear. It's a sideball as well.
There's no way he's going to show me up like this. Frad goes scrambling up behind him.
Okay, roll me a D20, Frad. Let's see how athletic you are.
A six.
You scramble up the same way, but you upon seeing the side ball, it takes your attention away, and you
slip. The ball.
And you put the rest of your toes on your foot.
Oh my god,
Fred, that's gonna need a splint.
No, it's fine. I can walk. But then I fall over, and now I'm prone on the ground.
Oh my gosh, Mr. President.
That means he can't move until his next turn.
Right.
Oh no, guys, because clouds are rolling in. I think I see some lightning on the horizon.
Yeah. Stop being a know-it-all.
But even though he's acting like a know-it-all, unfortunately, he knows it all. For the lightning is rolling in, and the dark clouds, and where the Saturn used to be, there is now the outline of a tall, thin, man with no joints.
Fuck.
Just doing a weird wobbly arm fling.
Albert Bender told us all about this, guys, decades ago.
Right.
Guys, we said it was just going to be the four of us. Who invited this guy?
I don't know. I put a text out to everyone, but I don't recognize him.
Oh, Chrissy.
Fred, why don't you grow another toe so you can break it?
Yeah,
this 1992 texting is fucking sick.
Way ahead of its time.
You guys, I'm so horny. Anything's possible.
And upon saying horny, you hear some thumping from the bedroom.
Guys, this isn't fair.
I can't get down. I jump.
No, roll me a D20 to see how cool you land.
He rolled a 10.
He rolled a 10.
Right in the middle all the time, buddies. On the face.
It's like he's a child at a gymnastics class, and he just jumped and landed pretty okay. You know, nothing too...
Oh, that wasn't that bad.
Fred, high five.
My sideball.
But then he farts just a tiny bit, and everyone can hear.
No, that's sulfur. That's from the tall, leggy man.
Okay.
And the thumping from the bedroom is louder and gets louder and louder.
Oh my God.
Guys, we gotta go check this out.
Yeah, we totally gotta go check this out.
The door is closed.
That's right. The door is closed.
I feel like we're being railroaded right here. This is a D&D term.
Yes. You look down and you see two sets of railroad tracks leading straight into the bedroom.
Oh my God, I freaking get so horny for trains.
Well, I guess we should go check out the bedroom.
Can't wait.
I'll come.
Well, unfortunately, the door is locked.
Don't worry, guys. I have a huge bobby pin. I can pick this. It's not my first, and it certainly won't be my last time doing this.
Ooh, yes. Whoa. This is also, we know that Chrissy has quite the charisma at school. And she's going to use that to try and open up this lock. So you get a charisma bonus of +5, Chrissy. Why don't you roll a d20 and see what you get? And we'll add 5 to it.
Amazing. My pleasure. I rolled a 17, 18.
Oh my God, +5. You barely even touch the lock with the bobby pin. And the door flies off the hinges.
Did it.
And it hits Fred in the toe.
Oh. Right in the toe.
Fred, your freaking toes. You're the president.
And Fred is knocked prone once again.
Oh my God, Fred.
Fred, is there anything you can do with it?
Oh, I just had a couple too much White Claws.
Oh my God. So what's happening in this bedroom?
Yeah, what do we see in the bedroom?
Oh, well, there is a mist, a bloodied miasma that fills the bedroom. Why don't you, all four of you roll a d20? Who can see the most? Who gets the highest roll?
Okay, so we'll do Fred. Oh, Fred can roll. What did you get?
8.
Okay. 8. And Jan got a 2.
Ooh.
And Jason got a 10.
10.
Okay.
And I got a 19.
Ooh. Chrissy, the high roller of the gang. Mm-hmm. She can see through the mist. Everyone else, your eyes are befuddled by this bloodied mist. But Chrissy can see straight through it. And Chrissy can see the first boy that she lost her virginity to.
Oh my God. Brian?
Yes. Except Ryan's eyes are bleeding.
Oh my God. Did you freaking fall or something?
And he says, babe, I want to rekindle our relationship.
Oh,
and
my
he
God.
Disappears into the mist. Do you follow or do you stay with your friend?
Well, honestly, like, he was a Gemini and I was a Pisces, but I think I need to run after it just to see.
Oh, my. All right. Chrissy runs into the bloodied mist.
No, Chrissy, no!
And she disappears. It is only the three of you left.
Well, there's four of us because me and my nerdy friends built this hot woman who can actually walk and talk now, too. She's right
cool.
here.
All right. What's that woman's name?
Donna.
Oh, my God. Is this like a Bill and Ted's Bogus Journey type thing?
It's kind of more like a weird science thing, but
yes.
We were all going to practice kissing, so we built a woman.
Could you build me a new toe?
Sure. I just need the right stuff.
You find it right in front of you.
Great. I have exactly enough stuff for 3 toes.
Oh, good.
Okay. Well, I mean, I didn't lose my toe. So what do we do here?
We add toes.
Roll me a d20 to see how many new toes you make for Fred.
I rolled a 3 this time.
You make 3 new toes for Fred.
It worked out perfectly.
Yes, absolutely. Great. So what do? You're standing in front of this bedroom with this bloodied mist, and you just lost your friend Chrissy, who ran after her boyfriend.
I put my pack on my ring of promise, and I run after her. Dive into the mist.
The ring of promise gives you +7 constitution. Roll me another d20 to see how well you make it through the bloody mist and add 7 to it.
Okay. 13 +7, so exactly 20.
Fantastic. Filbert, as you run in, you hear the catcalls of all the cool kids yelling at you. Hey, stupid loser.
No.
Hey, you're an idiot. Why don't you go kiss your own mom again, Filbert? Because they all saw you kissing your own mother.
That was for a picture, Damon. Fuck.
And as the spirits dissipate, you see the corpse of Chrissy in front of you.
Oh, no.
And one full boob is exposed.
Oh, no.
Hey, lean into it. Don't act like you're not impressed.
That's right.
I'm
I want to be with her forever. This is my Romeo and Juliet moment. I take out my scalpel and slit my throat.
You successfully kill yourself. Yes. Roll me a d20 to see how much you kill yourself.
7.
Yes, you kill yourself. 7. You are 7 dead.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. 2 of you have lost your life inside the bloodied mist of the bedroom. Now stands Frad and Colleen, eyeballing each other, one with a foot filled with broken toes, and the other foot with 3 fake toes. Colleen furiously jotting down notes on her notepad so that she can properly report this. What next?
Oh, and Fred's grabbing his foot, and he looks up at Colleen, and he says, "Oh, Colleen, if this is the end, I need to confess something to you."
What is it, Fred?
I'm a virgin. I'm a virgin, Colleen.
But you're the president of the football club.
I know, but I'm just so shy. You see, I always looked up to people like Filbert who were brave enough to go venturing into dark mists and all that. And well, I don't want to die a virgin.
Well, Fred, I guess I could help you out.
Yes, let's see how successful this persuasion is. Fred, why don't you roll and see if you can have sex with Colleen?
This is freaking bullshit. Here's my
persuasion roll. It's a 6.
Ooh.
It's a 6.
Not too persuasive. Colleen, does that work?
Listen, Fred, I don't know if I can go all the way. I mean, 2 of our friends just died. Yep. My dad's car is missing. He's going to be so mad.
Wait, we came back as ghosts. If someone is going to have sex, it should be you.
I killed myself and okay. I'm still a virgin.
I get it. I mean, I do have a thing for, you know, people playing with my feet.
What?
Well, listen, Fred, take off your shoes and let me see what you're working with.
Okay, so I take off my foot, my shoe that's on the broken foot with all the broken toes.
Ugh. And what you see, Colleen, is just nubs of purple and black, dislocated toes and joints. And as you look down, the tall, slender man approaches the door, the front door that you stupidly left open. Nobody closed it after you came back in. So the door is open and this tall, thin man is making his way into the room. Meanwhile, you look into the bloodied room of mist and you see your 2 friends, Filbert and Chrissy, furiously making out as ghosts.
Well, Colleen.
I think Fred died.
I think Fred died.
What do you see?
Oh, he's back.
I couldn't hear what you said, Fred.
You see, Colleen.
Well, this really sounds like 1992.
Yes.
I see the tall slender man and he looks like our chemistry teacher.
That's right. It's Mr. Papa Constantino. Your chemistry teacher, who used to be your physical geography teacher.
Oh God.
Well, maybe if he sees us making out, then he'll leave.
I think we should all make out.
Yes. You should all make out. Let's get everyone roll a make out roll. How much do you make out?
Okay. I rolled a 17.
Ooh, not bad.
Jan rolled an 8.
Ooh, not good. Fred, What did you roll?
I rolled a 19.
Oh, 19, Filbert. What did Filbert roll?
He rolled an 18.
Oh, my Lord. Fred and Filbert and Chrissy all lean in and wield the eldritch darkness that fills the room, twists their tongues together as they furiously make out.
I've got two sideballs out now.
Both balls are out. And as you look at Chrissy, she only has one boob.
Ooh.
I'm into it.
Colleen backs away. She rolled an 8, so her making out is super shit.
Your tongue's a bit grainy.
Sorry, suddenly, I had a lot of Werther's Originals on the way up.
You've got no lips.
Fred, who rolled the highest, he makes out so hard with the ghost of Chrissy and Filbert, he gets sucked into the bloody mist. And a fountain of blood and sinew spurt out the door. Colleen, you are covered in the gore of your three friends. And you have a tall
get the hell out of here.
You get out of there?
Yeah.
All right. Colleen, you run out the door. You find your car. You forgot to put the parking brake on, so it just rolled a little down the hill. It's a Saturn, remember? It's quite shitty.
My dad's always telling me not to forget the parking brake.
Yes. And as you make it to your car, you get in and drive away from the cabin in the woods, only to find that the road ahead has been destroyed by the balls and boobs of Christian Filbert.
No!
The end, you're all dead.
Brad breaks another toe.
Roll to see how broken it is.
20!
Yes! Yes!
Oh, that's what we were waiting for. Your entire foot breaks off.
I don't feel it because I'm a ghost. Whee! Brad goes flying up to the sky.
Oh.
Was that our adventure?
That is it.
I love it.
That's how fun D&D is.
No, that's really fun. You have to come back and do like we have to do a full hour. Would be so fun.
But if you love listening to it, you guys, I mean, let's be honest, you guys have it already mastered. Stacy put it up in the chat, but maybe we let people know too, like you guys murdered this already in another podcast.
So tell us a little bit about your podcast, and we have all the links in the description so you can follow it too. So, but tell us about it.
Sure. Our podcast is it's called an actual play D&D podcast, where we play D&D just like this, but with a lot more of the real rules, and we go through it, and it takes a long time. Do you hear me? Am I coming in?
No, you're coming
in. Okay, I laugh at like, except we do it real, because like obviously this podcast is very
this was real.
This was ridiculous.
I spent a long time putting this campaign together.
This campaign was amazing.
It was amazing.
You don't know how nerdy we get and how much we indulge and how real it is. Like
But we can find out by listening and watching.
I will say that you're getting compliments. Fred is the only person I know that looks good with an up angle. Let me tell you, I've been, harassing him for years. I agree. The looks are correct.
You got to see my down angle.
please.
You know what? You can see a lot of our down angle on our a podcast.
Yes.
DwarvenMoss.com.
Bringing it back. Nice.
Yes.
And I'll say this. Dwarven Moss, it's easily rememberable, is that it's the strain of weed that our characters smoke in our fantasy world.
I will say this.
That makes it easier to remember, for sure.
Chris and Jay are truly some of the most talented people that I've ever worked with, ever seen perform, ever known. They're so fucking talented. And their podcast is next level. The music, the scoring, the anime, like the trailer alone, like I'm so fucking excited. Like it is something to really enjoy and get into, I have to say.
Thanks, also, Dave, didn't you just score a movie that you should say the name of?
Oh, yeah. I scored a movie that's called The Kid Detective, and it's coming out in theaters next week.
Amazing.
It was out in America, and now it's doing Canada and UK.
That's amazing.
It's a really fun movie starring Adam Brody of The OC. So if you like Seth, you get a whole bunch of them in this one.
I was a big, big Seth from The OC lover. So Adam Brody, yum.
A hunk.
Now that's a hunk.
That's a guy who looks good from a down angle or an up
down angle, up angle, whatever angle. Angle. Yeah, get on the roof and show me your nuts. You know what I mean?
He shows his ass in this movie.
He does? Well, I'll be first in line. That's amazing. So we will put all the links below. But I'm inviting you on.
Wait, he shows his ass in The Kid Detective?
Yeah.
Okay.
You've never walked in on your dad in the bathroom. He just goes, "Yeah, what are you gonna do? I'm here."
Well, yeah, not sideball, full ball.
Where else can people find you?
Me?
Yeah, both of you guys.
Oh, I'm around.
Oh yeah, you're on the band, the show, an amazing show. Yeah, he's an incredible musician. Sadiq's. We got Bit Players.
Yes, Bit Players, and you can find me in Little Italy.
It's the best. I want to thank you guys so much for coming. Now, Jason, we have been sent a very secret video. I thought we would play the video and then we will come back and end the stream. Mm-hmm. I want to thank Chris and Jay for coming on. Follow them. We have all their information for Dwarven Moss in the description. So follow them and listen. And we will have you guys back very soon to do a full D&D show with us. Because I would love to get another wig going and a full character.
You can see people are on board.
Yeah, Amanda said she's never watched anything like that and she's going to have to tune in. So that's amazing.
Oh, Amanda, you're not ready for this.
So, bye, boys. So, we have been given a video. We have not seen it. Jenny sent it to us, Cirillo, and we got it in. We don't know what it's about, so we're going to play it, and then we'll have some final thoughts. How does everyone feel about that?
I feel great.
Amazing. Okay.
I feel like I wanted to give more to that D&D thing. I feel like I really loved it.
That's a classic, Jason. So, let's play this video, and here we go.
An eerie sight, for my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the match.
He did the monster match.
The monster match.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the match.
It caught on in a flash.
He did the match.
He did the monster match.
This is from Jason and Elizabeth. They're coming dressed as Jason's shirt of mispronounced words. Thank you guys for all the love and the laughter these past few months. Your community loves you.
Hey, all you cool cats and kittens. Jason and Stacey, thank you so much for creating the Regulars community. It has truly been a light through this whole pandemic, as Stacey would say, and I can't wait to keep laughing with you guys and watching you guys grow. Happy Halloween.
Hey, Jason and Stacey, just wanted to say happy Halloween and thank you so much for building such an amazing community around the Regulars. I love watching you guys every Monday, Wednesday, Friday.
And today we're doing a workout that's pretty good.
Dracula and
all time.
The scene was rocking, all were digging the sounds. Igor on chains, backed by his baying hounds. The coffin bangers were about to arrive with their vocal group, the Crypt Kicker Five.
They played the match.
They played the monster match.
The monster match.
It was a graveyard smash.
They played the match.
Hey, Stassi, Jason. No, over here. Happy Halloween.
My God!
Oh, God.
Oh, no!
so worried because I was like, did Jenny want us to play this before the tarot thing? Because I thought it might have something to do, but that's incredible.
Oh my God. I wish I wasn't wearing this dumb fucking wig. Oh my God. How did you do? So Jenny says, thank you to everyone we managed to stalk on Instagram and DM. Shout out to Shayla and Jan for their help nabbing people. Jan!
What, you knew about this?
You're nasty. Love it. Oh my God, that just made my whole freaking life.
Well, I think you guys know. I mean, like, this podcast, you know, you say it all the time. You started out thinking you were just going to do it for 2 weeks. It's been like almost 8 months.
What? How long has it been?
Like almost 8 months. I know, like, for me, and I think I speak for a lot of the folks who join in regularly, like, this is like basically what I base my day around because I have nothing else going on. Like, when someone's like this meeting, I'm like, yeah, but it'll have to be after two. So I want to say thank you. And I'm sure, like, you can see from the video how appreciated you are.
Oh my God.
For just basically like giving us a laugh, letting us have our soft days, giving us a whole new vocabulary.
Was that the actual snake king that came in at the end?
I think it might be.
Wow. This, because I will say, like, we have just had the best time in our entire lives. Like, again, it started out as a 2-week shenanigan, and like, literally to have a Halloween spooktacular. Sorry, it's my dogs are starting to play, which they never do behind. They're jacked up. This means the world. It was just like, I feel like we just saw all of our friends having a party.
That was too much. And I want that sweater too. That was a sick sweater.
I know we're going to have to put that up, make that official. What we can't, like, Jason and I are people who really fight emotions in all aspects. I can tell you we're for sure going to have a soft cry while washing off this makeup about like everyone in the chat. Jay, how do you feel?
Well, my son's in that too. And I was like, I didn't know about any of this.
But I like that he took that moment to brag about how he was working out and you were doing a podcast talking about how gross you feel. Rochelle, that's what it is. Thank you, Stacey and Jason. You've really made this whole lockdown here so bearable. I can't be in the chat because you're usually on at 3 a.m. Understandable. And Melissa just got a call from...
What else you got to do at 3 a.m.? You know what I mean?
Oh my God. That really touched our hearts.
I'm really bad at taking compliments. Well, we both are bad at taking compliments and everything. So this is too much. That was too nice.
So lovely. Oh my gosh. My day is just, Megan just said, first time in the chat. Love y'all. Always uplifting and just a joy. Thank you so much, Megan. That's so nice. We love doing it. We're going to continue. What? 4 more years?
As long as the pandemic's going.
Well, I believe the pandemic is here to stay. You're all just such treasures. We wouldn't get through the days without all of you. So this is so sweet. It just feels ridiculous. Jason's got a cornhole in the back. I got the fucking wig that's making me so greasy. And Jan's the sexy one who's like, huh? Well,
this is like you think you're having some friends over to go swimming in a pool, and it turns out it's your surprise birthday party.
This is exactly how it felt.
I wish you could have seen us in the background just going watching it.
That's the most surprised I think I've ever been in my life.
I know. That was, oh my God, my heart is so full. We're going to put that up on our Instagram so everyone, so I can watch it again and again and again and again.
Thanks to everybody for putting that out. That's
true. And I guess we're going to thank everyone for watching. We want to thank all of our pals for being on this show. Thank you for being silly with us and taking time out of your lives to do that. Follow all of the people. They're all amazing. They're all incredible creators. Doing.
Sadiq's is still hanging out backstage. He's ready to rock. He's like, he's treating this like an actual theater.
Ha ha ha. think he's the best. Jan, thank you so much. Follow Jan, Two Little Sandwiches. Follow Jenny. So this is, we were talking about giveaways. We are going to be doing a giveaway. So how this is going to work is we're going to just put a random generator. So we've got everyone that was in the chat. I guess we'll put it up on Instagram. So check that out. And we will reach out to everyone personally. But what we're giving away is... we're going to give away a sweater from our merch shop, the classic regular sweater. We're giving away a mug, and we're giving away an amazing tarot card reading from Jenny.
Jenny Cirillo has been so nice. She works on that video, and now she wants to do a friggin' tarot card reading. So beautiful.
So we're going to put that up on our Instagram, and we'll talk about it on Monday, but you'll be contacted before then. So we will do that. Now, Jan, I just thought maybe we could do one last walk before we leave.
Sure.
And now, this can be an hour-long walk if you need to be.
But we just thought, if anyone has it in the chat, get it in now for Jan. But Jason, I've given a suggestion. Do you want to give Jan a lovely last Halloween spectacular walk for the Halloween whatever? I've lost my mind from that video. I'm still thinking about it.
Yep.
Okay.
And it's Popeyes.
Popeyes
chicken. All right. Popeyes chicken is a brand of fried chicken based on a character, Popeye the Sailor Man, who was a sailor. He ate spinach. Spinach is green. What is also a slang for green is you call money green. Money is said to be the root of all evil. Evil is like scary, spooky ghosts and goblins, devil's night. Devil's night is the night before Halloween.
Woo! Short jaunt. Just an easy jaunt for that Jan Caruana.
Amazing. I love it. So just a quick thing. Jenny says, message me at Jenny Cirillo or Three Light Events and we can chat about a reading. So please contact her. I can tell you, having gotten a reading from Jenny, it's wonderful. It's so, if you're nervous about it, she makes you feel so at ease. It's such a comfortable experience. And I took so much from it. So, but we will be contacting the winner from the reading. Jason, is there anything else you want to say?
I'm still like in my head about Snake King knew my brother's name. So the mystery of Snake King is, it's real. I'm Sherlock Holmesing this shit eventually. But
Snake King, seems like an eternity ago.
I know it seems like an eternity ago. We've lived three lives. I love that.
It was our longest pod ever, for sure.
It was our longest pod. But I will say, like, someone reached out to Snake King in the DM. And for that, I don't even know how that happened.
Yeah. And what a perfect that this person has named themselves online Snake King and not only been like, it was just a silly name one time, has a pumpkin with a full on like killer snake on it.
That's fucking
amazing. Very committed to this.
Avatar too.
Very committed.
They wanted to stay a mystery. And for that, I applaud. I love keeping a bit going. You know, that's why the stream was 2 hours. I want to thank you all again. We're gonna gush and mush and do all the things again on Monday because that video I'll keep watching. We love you all so much. I think we've created such an amazing little corner of the internet with no pervs, which is incredible. Obviously, if you are a perv and you're like, I'm in the wings, don't come out.
Well, Chrissy's the only perv that we've ever allowed on this show.
I'm horny for murder. Thank you.
Isn't every next podcast?
How does everybody know about octopuses with Charlie too? Like, what is happening in my lifetime? The simulation is happening because I'm.
Does he like octopuses?
That's his big thing right now. We carved a pumpkin that is an octopus for him.
Okay, we got to unpack this on Monday. Thank you for listening. Thank you for being here today. Thank you to Jan. Thank you to Chris Wilson, the disappointed ghost. Thank you to Jenny Cirillo, to Alex Kalenko, to Chris Siddiqui, to Jane Carroll, to Mr. Casual, to Adam Colley, to everyone who did the video. It was just, what a treat.
And to Sheldon. And Sheldon for sitting across from Jan Caruana through this entire thing playing video games.
I know, with her boobs out the way they are and that little fuzzy velour. Oh my God. I wish you all a really lovely weekend. Have some fun, throw on a wig, eat some candy. We all deserve it. Jason, anything else?
Happy fucking Halloween, everybody.
Happy fucking Halloween. And we will see you all on Monday.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.